Today we're going to talk about one of the most commonly used words in the weight room, and that is posture. The reason that we're going to talk about it is because although it's commonly used, we've recognized that not all athletes know exactly what we mean when we say it. So when we'll ask a group of athletes, in fact we did it this week, what do we mean by posture? You'll get responses like straight back. Well, that isn't posture. You'll get a response like head up. Okay, maybe a component of posture, but not posture in and of itself. If they're a really experienced athlete, you might get things like maintain a neutral spine, which is a great term if you know what it means. So the way that we identify posture and the way we explain it to young people is we say, imagine a spine, okay? Think about being in a science classroom. Imagine a spine. The spine doesn't go straight up and down, okay? And it's not just your lower back. Your posture begins at the base of your skull with the cervical spine, moves through the thoracic spine, moves down into the lumbar spine, and ultimately fits into the hips, essentially. So the spine is moving through each one of those regions. You'll notice there's always minor curvature. There's subtle variations at each stage of spine. So when we talk about posture, what we say is maintain the natural curvature of the spine. We want to support the natural curvature of the spine so that it can be maintained throughout movements. Whether we are a football linebacker, hips back, eyes on a swivel, a swimmer trying to get full extension in any one of their strokes, however you want to apply it, or maybe this is the biggest idea, just a human being trying to stay healthy for a lifetime, we have to start with posture. We talk about posture from the ground up. Okay, so the first thing we say, you'll notice as we have a group of people sitting around, you'll notice some are just kind of leaning, whatever. We all have these natural leans to ourselves. So what we're gonna do though is we're gonna start from the ground up. First things first with posture, go ahead and steady your feet, even weight distribution across your feet, directly below your hips. Now we ask people to put their hands on their hips and just notice if there's any funky alignments. Just get steady before we then begin to move up to the thoracic and cervical spine. We can't talk about posture without talking about the shoulder blades, okay? Having control over the shoulder blades, making sure that they're aligned to support the natural curvature of the spine. Now, I semi-poorly traced the scapula, one of the shoulder blades on Coach Clem's back with masking tape here just to illustrate. The shoulder blade, the name comes from the actual anatomical look of the bone back here. It looks like the blade of a hatchet or an axe, the head of a hatchet or an axe. It's triangular like this. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna look at the 1, 2, 3, the third and most distant point of the shoulder blade as it sits far from the shoulder here. Matt right now is in sort of a rounded posture. This is like sitting at your computer posture or on your phone or tablet type posture. And you'll notice that that third point of the shoulder blade is pretty far away from his spine. So all the musculature through here is elongated, and that could happen over many hours over the course of the day. Go ahead and contract, and hopefully if the shirt moves with his body, you'll notice that here's his spine now. Look how much the distance has changed from scapula to spine. Okay, he's now in a state of semi-contraction, but he's not overdoing it. He's not arching his back in any way. This is just the natural alignment. Matt, go ahead and turn to your right, just pivot to your right so we can see you from a side view. He's not overdoing it. He's just supporting, as we keep saying over and over, the natural curvature, in this case, of the thoracic spine. The next two essential components of posture as we look at it are shoulder and jaw. I'll explain each individually. So from a side view, as we talk about very regularly, we're in this position where the musculature of the upper back is extended for long periods of time, and we're actually contracted through the pec and the anterior deltoid. The front of the shoulder kind of gets tight because this is where we are, long, short. So one thing that we want to pay attention to, especially as coaches, is where does the shoulder sit relative to the collarbone or to the clavicle? If we're sitting at a computer, it will be in front, and you can actually feel it. If you trace the clavicle, you'll get a minor indentation before the anterior deltoid begins. So what we're looking for is not this position, but one where the shoulder is at or behind clavicle level, depending on how pronounced the clavicle might be. So I actually like checking, using this shirt as an example, if you can see, the line down the side, the stripe or the seam down the top of the shirt. If I'm rolled, it's sort of pointing forward. You can see that my posture, it's not egregious, but it's not great. And if I set my shoulder blades back and through that pull my actual shoulder aligned with my clavicle, now you'll notice that the seam moves straight down my arm. So, and you also might be able to tell that if you set the shoulder blades correctly, a lot of times this is happening sort of automatically. So if you set the shoulder blades down and back correctly, the shoulder itself will align, which is great. The next joint that we're gonna look at is the hinge of the jaw. We're also gonna use the clavicle as a reference, and all we wanna see is the jaw. You know, sometimes we forget that the cervical spine is part of the spine and part of posture. Of course, it absolutely is. So what we don't want is a jaw that's in front of the clavicle, again, mirroring just being on a computer. What we do want is a jaw that sits just above the clavicle, okay? You'll notice sort of an L shape from jaw toward up toward the ear, if we've got it right, and if not, we're sort of out of whack there. So that's the final component to it. And when we get this right, I'm telling you, to have a thoughtful concept of what posture is gives you a great jumping off point for not only teaching posture to your athletes, but maintaining posture through training and in sport. We use the term put your posture into it. So put your posture into the bench, okay, before you bench press. Set your posture before you put a bar on your back to squat. Get posture before you pull something off the ground or begin any of the Olympic movements, okay? So understanding what posture is, teaching posture as one of the absolute essential ideas of strength and conditioning, and then applying that and coming back to it, revisiting it over and over and over again is essential. And the final bit of advice for both coaches and athletes is to come back to an idea that we refer to all the time, and that is don't get bored being right. Working on posture isn't as cool as squatting 500 pounds or setting a new Olympic lifting max or hitting a new 40 time, a brand new record or a personal record at least. It's not as fun as that necessarily, but I will tell you that it just might lead to that. Not only will it lead to that, but as we've mentioned a number of times, it'll keep you safe for a lifetime. And if that's not the goal of training ultimately, then I don't know what it is. So don't get bored being right. Refer back to posture often. And coaches, make sure your athletes know what you mean when you use the word.